and today I am going to walk you through all of the steps that you need to know so that you can make 4 different baby blankets using double gauze fabric. Now, a few things to mention. Double gauze fabric is a very lightly woven fabric, which is why it is very popular when using it with baby blankets. And I suggest using a number 3 stitch length when sewing these double gauze baby blankets. And of course, I'm going to talk about washing your baby blankets at the very end of this video, so definitely stick around to the end so that you don't miss that as well. All right, let's jump into all of those tutorials. Essentially, this video has 2 tutorials going through it because my first 2 baby blankets I will explain at the same time, and then the next 2 baby blankets I will explain at the same time. This quilt here can be done with or without the ruffle. So you'll take a square piece of double-sided gauze. For myself, I cut out a 27-inch by 27-inch piece of gauze, and you will actually need 2 pieces of this gauze fabric. And then if you're choosing to add a ruffle around your blanket, cut out strips of the double-sided gauze 3 inches wide, and you will need around 160 inches worth of these strips. So for myself, I just pinned them right sides together and then sewed a 1/2-inch seam across each edge to create a really long strip of 3-inch wide fabric. Then I took this strip of fabric to my iron and I doused it in my best press, which I will have linked in the description down below, folded it wrong sides together, and then ironed it in half. To see the specifics on how I made this ruffle, I will link up above as well as down below to my ruffle tutorial, 2 ways to make a ruffle, and I used the easy method to make this particular ruffle. Once I turned those strips of fabric into a ruffle, then I laid my gauze fabric, just a single layer, right side up, and I put my ribbon all the way around the outer edge. Now I just quickly had a look to make sure I had enough ribbon. If you don't have enough ribbon, then just add 1 more section to the end of your ribbon before you end up attaching your ribbon to this fabric. So I'll just pin all the way around, watching out for those corners. I will fold in my fabric a little bit more and do an extra pin on those corners just to keep them from ending up folded into the seam itself. Once the ribbon has been attached all the way around, I will match up the 2 ends of my double-sided gauze and just cut off the excess. And then I'll actually pick out some of the seam about 3 inches in, just enough that I can open up the end of that double-sided gauze, and I'll do that on both sides. Then I will line up the edge of my double-sided gauze, I'll take it to the sewing machine, and I will just sew a 1/2-inch seam along the top, or a 1-inch seam, depending on how much space you left when you cut the excess off. It doesn't have to be perfect because you're working with a ruffle and you're working with really nice squishy double-sided gauze, so any imperfections that you end up making will be hidden by the adorable fluffiness that is double-sided gauze. So right here, I'm just going to take it to the sewing machine and I'm going to attach our 2 end pieces of our ruffle together. And then I will line it up along my outer edge and finish clipping it in place. And then it's time to add our 2nd piece of double-sided gauze on top. So we'll lay that one right side facing down and we will just attach it all the way around the outer edge, making sure to mark 1 area with pins instead of clips. I like to do this because then I don't forget what I'm doing when I bring this to the sewing machine. And just mark a section around 3 to 4 inches in width with your pins, and you will not sew over that section because that's the section that you will need to turn this entire project right side out. Then take it to your sewing machine starting at 1 pin, sew all the way around the entire outer edge at a 1/2-inch seam allowance, stopping at the next pin. So you'll end up leaving that 3 to 4 inch opening. Now, if you are doing this without the ruffle, all you would do is lay your 2 pieces of double-sided gauze together. You would do this exact same thing, pin it all together, leaving that 3 to 4 inch opening on one end, and you will take it to the sewing machine and do this next step. So I sewed around the entire outer edge minus that pinned area at about a 1/2-inch seam allowance. When I made my ruffle, I created my ruffle at a 1/4-inch seam allowance. That way way, now when I'm sewing across my ruffle, I'm hiding the seam that created the ruffle in the first place. Once you've sewn around the entire blanket, then just clip away those corners, and any excess ruffle that you have, just clip that away as well. We're essentially just trying to get rid of as much bulk as possible. And then it's time to turn it right side out, making sure to point out all four corners. I like to use a chopstick to do this, but just be very gentle, that way you don't push out the entire corner. And once you've done that, then take it to your iron and just press down around the entire outer edge. I like to do this using my best press because it makes the fabric a lot more crisp. And while it's crisp, it makes it much easier to sew. And while you're ironing around the entire outer edge, make a special note of the opening and iron in that seam on both sides, and then line up the ruffle on the inside between the two of them and then pin that shut. And of course, if you're not adding a ruffle, then this part is a lot easier. Just fold those pieces in, iron, and pin across. Then take it to your sewing machine, and we are going to sew as close as we can to our ruffle or the outer edge of your fabric. So at a quarter inch seam allowance would be best. That way you'll be able to close in that ruffle and opened seam. Or like I said, if there's no ruffle, you'll still end up closing in that seam. And if you're not using a ruffle, then just line your sewing foot along the edge of your fabric. And that will be a nice guide for how to sew around the entire piece of fabric. And once you've sewn around this entire piece of fabric, then your opening should be sewn shut. And just like that, you have learned our first two techniques on making a baby blanket with double gauze. Once it's washed, it has this beautiful crinkled look to it, and I am sure that anybody you gift this baby blanket to will be thrilled to have it. Now, we are going to move on to our next two baby blankets. Those baby blankets are going to be larger, and they are going to act as more of a swaddling baby blanket. Before we jump into the next tutorial, I do want to show you, I don't know if you can tell, but if you look at the hem, you'll see the stars from the star fabric. And then it's just the single layer here. So that's the tutorial I will walk you through. However, if you end up using different fabric on the opposite side, then what will end up happening is you'll have this beautiful dark border lining a lighter, well, I can only assume you would pick a lighter fabric. And it would just have a really nice border effect. So that's the difference between those two baby blankets for the most part. The tutorial will be pretty much the same. However, the biggest difference is just how lightweight it will be. You're using a single layer versus two layers. So let's jump into the next two tutorials. To make the largest blanket that we can, we're going to take the corner of one selvedge edge and fold it over to create this triangle. And then we will just cut across that outer edge. I like to do this with a rotary cutter and my quilter's ruler. This particular blanket is going to end up being 39 inches by 39 inches, but if you buy a different brand of gauze, you may even be able to get a larger swaddle blanket from your fabric. Now, if you want to do a double-sided gauze blanket, then you will cut out two of these and then lay them wrong sides together, right sides facing out. But for myself, I'm just going to do this single piece of fabric here. So I am going to use my best press as well as my measuring gauge, which I will have linked in the description down below. Take it on over to the iron, and I am going to measure in at a half an inch, and I'm going to iron the edge a half an inch in, and then a half an inch in again to create a really nice hem. Now, if you are doing the double-sided gauze, then make sure that you are folding both edges in towards the same direction. Once you've folded one edge in all the way, then start and do the same thing on the next edge. The best press is just there to help keep things crisp and stiff, as double-sided gauze is a bit of a wiggly fabric. Once all four edges have been pinned in place, then it's time to take it to the sewing machine, and we will sew around the entire outer edge. Preferably don't start on a corner. I always start on a corner. I don't know why, because it's way harder. So start somewhere in the middle and line up your needle with the inner edge of your hem. So I have about a quarter inch seam between the needle and the inside hem. And of course, start with a backstitch. Then when you come to the corner, sew all the way to the end and then go back, turn your fabric, sew to the end again, and then you can continue going forwards. Sometimes you may need to use a sewing stiletto or a chopstick to get the fabric moving again, and that will secure each corner quite nicely. Then of course, finish with a back stitch and you're done.
And once all of that is said and done, you will end up with a nice, large, lightweight swaddling blanket, which again, I think would make an amazing baby gift. So now for the washing instructions of your baby blanket. So what I do is I throw it in my wash on a warm cycle, and then I actually throw it into my dryer on high. Now, of course, depending on where you buy your fabric, different companies may have different directions for you, but it's something that I prefer to do. That way it's already been pre-shrunk before I end up gifting it to someone. I do not pre-wash it before I make these baby blankets, and the reason being, once you wash them, as you can see, they get nice and crinkled up, which makes it so much harder when you're actually sewing the baby blanket together. So that's what I do when I wash and dry these baby blankets to get them prepared as baby gifts. But if you have any other suggestions, please leave them in the comments down below. I would love to see what you have to say about your double gauze experiences as well. And as always, please hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss future tutorials. I hope that you have a wonderful day, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.